reach that, but Aldo has got no ranking at all because of her age, so there she is. I can't imagine that Jing Yi would struggle here, but the big question mark is over her actual health. Can you believe that she's back on court again today?
She had no choice. I mean, look at this way. I think her opponent will not be as challenging as Chrissy Gilmore today, but how much damage can you go through with the pain as well as the injury that she has? Look at that. She's even trying out with the gingerly legs with a lot of balms or some kind of ointment on her left calf. It's not about the knee. It's a calf.
Yeah. Well, she, in the first day of competition when they played Vietnam, they put Ho Yen Mei up onto court. She actually lost. She was the only loser, so I think obviously they're not confident that Jing Yi can be replaced. So, well, we'll see how she struggles through. She's certainly not 100%. I think that's taken for granted. Korea wins, minus 10. And, well, that looks like it's a plus 9 on this year's scenario. So Jing Yi overall is looking pretty good this year. But she started out so badly. I think she was affected by some niggling injuries. There you go. There's not much we know about this young lady. She's lost more than she's won, both in this season and earlier. But again, just look at her youthfulness and a left-hander, of course. But we'll see how she's done. She picked up in both her matches previously. She picked up double points, which is really impressive. So Barredo played on the first day. And Aldo played on the second day against Singapore, lost 12-10 to Jia Yuan. And I think she also played against Thailand as well, she did, and lost 9-15 to Pontip Buranapasettu. And we've got a Thai umpire in the chair at the moment, so we'll be there. We will be underway in just a couple of moments, but yeah, it's going to be interesting. I think she will want to play this because obviously sharing in the spoils of a big win in KL would be very, very important. But she is definitely moving a little bit easier, although you can tell she's quite stiff. I think
ladies and gentlemen, on my right,
we shall see.
Malaysia,
maybe she can just stand in one place at the tee and just deliver.
She did at the beginning. Remember how much she just attacked immediately?
Represented by Airah Mae Nicole ALBO.
So Malaysia to start. Astro in Malaysia, if you're on the television.
Play.
Live streaming, cellcomescape.com. That's a good start.
So is all. Yes. One love.
We'll see if she can notice something. I know she is very tiny.
Semi-solo.
Short serve, one all. I think the ambition here is to put it where Jing Yi is not actually standing. They've got to try to get her moving.
Yeah.
It's a simple tactic, but I think it has to work. I've never seen anybody so distressed at the end of a match as yesterday.
The last two matches, remember, 2 days ago when she tried to get up with that racket bent?
Yeah. She's not looked the real deal, that's for sure. Under pressure. 3-1, though. Lovely drop shot.
Serve is over. 2-3.
I had a feeling as well that Jing Yi, I'm sure if she cannot play, she will tell the coach. So she is capable of playing and just feel the pain. And block the pain at all. Nice.
That is a lovely shot. And that's exactly the point that I was making. Mm-hmm. Put it where she isn't. Play a couple of shots, lull her into a false sense of security, and then drop one short. Test that knee, test the calf.
Very good.
It's out. Good play. She's got the lead. Good girl.
Very smart.
4-3.
Good to see. She's certainly not overall.
Ooh, she had it too.
Seven sorrow. Four all.
It's four all. She was warned by the umpire not to ask before she changes, didn't it? Last time that she thought about it on the way towards the shuttle change. Yeah, nice work.
Five,
not much in
four.
That, but you can tell she's not keen to chase around. She's not rushing to anything. It's out.
Yeah, she has to stay away from that.
Six,
she's been doing well. Once again, Yi decided to change the pace.
It's out again. You know, she's been so successful with those drop shots at the net. From that situation, you've got to try, I believe, dragging her forward. That's okay. Then the drop.
Very good, yes.
Yeah, it's horses for courses. She's got to think
seven,
who she's
zero,
playing
five,
and what a record
seven.
Is, you know? I'm sure the coaches have been thinking about it, but you don't just play as you would your own partners in training. You've got to find a way to disturb the opponent.
This is another thing. Is she able to? Is she willing to do it? That's another. Oh.
Semi-sorrow.
At least she's
eight,
trying to
five.
Change pace.
Yeah, a little bit.
Make it surprise, like you said, make it uncomfortable.
She has been 40 in the world ranking as Ti Jing Yi. That was in May
nine,
last year.
Five.
Actually, we've got a 33 against her now. I've just looked down, but that's strange.
Yes, it says
ten,
that she's
five.
50 now. I thought that she was like in her
30s. 30, 33, yeah. Wow. 10-5. Okay,
eleven,
they'll go to
five,
the break at 11 points to 5 in favor of Ti Jing Yi. There have been some moments for Airah ALBO. She has she's impressed on a couple of occasions, but now we need to see her think how she can upset the rhythm of Jing Yi. And at the moment, it's not happening.
Oh, she started like she wanted to play a rally. She wants to, like you mentioned, push it back, and then put it in front of Jing Yi. But once again, it's not as easy. Because Jindy as well understand the game.
Card one, 20 seconds. Card one, 20 seconds.
Cut it in front or hit it a lot earlier. Look at that. Appointment.
It really is strange. You're supposed to leave it there or are you going to rub it in?
11-5.
It hasn't been rubbed in.
Toto, you volunteered. Play. Go and do it quick.
Service Zoro, 6, 11.
6-11. That's out. 7-11.
7-11.
Not the most exciting encounter we've ever had on court, that's for sure. It's a little bit slow and deliberate. The interesting element is that's out.
Was it out? Oh,
yeah,
wow.
That's right. It was a good effort, but
12-7.
Knew exactly what she wanted to try to do, but it's 12-7. Generally speaking, the men's singles has been very, very solid, and the men's doubles have been
they're fun
great,
to watch.
Great fun.
Yes. Because the reason is because
that's
they're
out.
Quick and fast.
13-7.
13-7.
Done. You've got, I was just about to say, she's got to be moved away from that tee position.
13.
She gets away from the tee, or she's pushed away from the tee, Then you can put pressure on. That's exactly what she did. Good girl. There, yeah, she's away from it again now. And then
yes.
Another error. Good work.
9-13.
Keep the pressure on by pushing her around the court.
And she's trying. I mean, this Philippine girl, Airah Mae Nicole ALBO.
Well, it was just
experience.
Poor footwork, wasn't it? You know, you got to get ready to receive that stuff. Yeah, just look at it, so out of shape. 14-9. She was making a little bit of a push, so that's a bit unfortunate. Sounds as if I'm in one eye supporting the the Philippine girl. But I mean, to be quite honest, I think with the situation as it stands,
15,
you know that the Malaysians are clear favourites. They've got far more experience. It's good to encourage the youngsters.
Yes.
Yeah, the underdog, exactly that. That's out. It's 16-9.
16-9.
That is good. Now I follow it up. Okay, now drop it again down the other side. She's continuing down that side. I think she'll come unstuck with it. There you go. Oh, well
done.
Okay, I'm really pleased with that.
10,
because she had several opportunities, but that forehand drop down into the forehand corner of the net was absolutely aching to be played.
Yes, he was wide open.
So many times down here, right close to camera.
Play.
Maybe she's not comfortable with that kind of shot, so she decided to just go with what she knows.
But she's
knows.
Got to look at those options, and that's where that, you can tell you, that's
11,
where you would find that Jiggy would be vulnerable because of those leg problems. Stretching down is so, so tough. 11-16.
Out. Oh.
That's a shame. 17-11.
Accuracy. 17-11. Again, she's beaten by some
18,
very clever
11.
Play by Jing Yi at the net.
She can't be dictated. She has to make a...
Yeah. She's not forcing the pace at the moment, just keeping the shuttle in. Pushing one way is okay, but there you see, that's the problem. You're not going to get second chances. 19-11. Good. That's exactly where I'm thinking.
Yes, you
it
have
could have
it.
Been even wider.
12,
okay, got
19.
A little bit lucky with the net, but that's exactly where she's going to be vulnerable, and she won't like that. Okay, even closer, even tighter to the sideline. It's 20 points to 12, though, with that Jing Yi special.
12.
Forehand smash, drive more like. 20 points to 12, game point. That's out, that's it, 21-12.
First game went
very
by
impressed
Malaysia,
the way she had
12.
Moment, the girl from Philippines.
She has had her moments, no doubt. I mean, she definitely is big, big underdog here.
But oh, yeah.
She has played some good rallies, and I would love to see her stretch down in that forehand at net. That would be an added element that we haven't seen from her game yet.
about 120 seconds.
So, coming back into our court one coverage, it's Malaysia versus
second
the Philippines.
Game.
Second matchup at Axiata Cup 2014. Robin series. Penultimate day of competition. We've had six of them. This is the sixth, I should say.
You lost count already. That's why it's so tough for Jing to play 6 days in a row. I mean, it's not just a practice. I mean, she has to compete.
There was one alternative that they started with, the day one, they used Hoyeon Mei. She lost 19 and 13, but she lost to the 53-ranked Wu Ti Tong. After that, they relied on Jing Yi. That is the shot that I want. Yeah, okay, so the second time it was
two,
good for
Jing. One.
I haven't seen from Airah any shot that comes down into that forehand net position. Not many, anyway. So there's a lot of opportunity there. 2-1 to the Philippine girl. That's good. It's out.
Yes.
There is a little bit of a draft, a little bit of a breeze from right to left as we look at it from the overhead camera. There's no doubt at all about that. We've seen several out on this right flank that have drifted in and they've been left.
Nice.
Oh, that's exactly what I wanted to do. Oh, man, that's unlucky. It was out.
No, no,
it was out. It was definitely out. But that is, that's putting pressure on her.
Yeah, make it a run.
Yeah, definitely. Well, good effort, that. I'm glad to see it's in the armory now. I hope she tries it again, because don't be put off by the fact it's just a little bit too wide. 3-2. Jinny. Play, good catch.
Very
good. Oh, man.
She tried that shot.
Four, three.
Make her stretch, make a Jinji stretch. But look at her, she's probably 16 perhaps. I can't find her.
I can't either. I cannot find her age. But we'll see. Keep trying.
And as I said,
she
is playing in the top 50 in the world. This is probably a high school player.
5-4.
She was happy.
Service over. 5-5.
Okay, I've got it. Managed to find it. She is actually 21, believe it or not.
No, that's, is that the name? Jason.
Oh, wait a minute, sorry. No.
6-5.
Okay, check it out. Pressed the wrong button there, didn't I? Sorry.
Wow, what a nice push there by Aldo.
Service over, 6-6.
Great, that's lovely.
Yes.
Super shot for 6-6. We like that. She's 15.
That's what I thought.
She's 15 years old. Airah Mae Nicole ALBO, I've got here.
Yes.
ALBO on the sheet, ALBO on the BWF side.
At six.
So she's a registered player
in
the World Badminton Federation.
Yeah, absolutely. She played in the Smiling Fish Thailand International Series this year. She lost to Pasita. It was a no match in the end. She won in the first, let's see, the Jati BWF World Junior Championship. She had a first round win against Monica Fetnikova, 16 and 12, then lost out to Li Ying Ying of Malaysia, 14 and 6. Mixed team juniors, she was involved as well. Oh, she's had a few runouts this year. The Asian Youth under 19s as well. Lost out singles and doubles in that, but wow, okay. She's getting there, 15 years old. What a start to the career, and what an opportunity here for everyone at home to watch. 8-all in the second.
Well, both of them, I was surprised as well now. They're just playing the hit the shuttle. The score is quite tight, 9-8.
That's out.
10-8. It's okay.
Gee, have you got the smell of coffee in your nose at the moment?
Yeah, I do.
It smells very nice.
Something from down there somewhere.
Take a bit of that, thank you.
That
is on the line. No, it's called long. It's called long.
So it's over. 9-10.
Nice pick up. Now can you? No, you can't. Much too tight play by Jingyi. Great net play by her. That takes it to the interval in the second. Only 2 points the difference, though. 11-9. Good stuff here from the youngster, isn't it?
Yeah, like I said, you know, she's been playing in a lot more than we thought, especially when she made it to second round of the World Championship, the Junior World Championship. And so she has had opportunity from the government of the Philippines to play on the international level in some ways.
I don't know how she gets on with the school activities at the moment. I mean, she's just had, well, this will be seven, 8 days, a whole week off school.
Hey, John, there's an internet that you can study through the...
Oh, I know all that stuff. I realize all that, but what an arrangement you have to make 11-9. To be so dedicated. In the United States, it's quite a popular thing. In Australia, it's quite popular.
My children's like that, too. That they would go on a trip of a sport for a couple of days, but has to do the homework.
Oh, that's a fabulous shot. Great play. Jingyi.
12-9.
Probably the best shot she's played this game. 12-9.
She doesn't look gimpy.
That's out. It's 13-9. She'll be disappointed with that. Some really good stuff to stay within touch, but now she's just drifting away. Lack of concentration and accuracy. He's gone as well.
You talked to any European 14, players after last
nine.
Night?
Pardon?
You talked to any European players?
They wouldn't talk to me about the match.
Oh, okay.
Just pleasantries.
Oh, okay. And you probably 15, stay away too.
I said, I actually said, obviously, bad luck, but you don't, they were not in the mood.
Yeah.
And they shouldn't be, because they had great chances to win it. 15-9, it was 11-9. That short.
15-9.
Trying all the right things, but not absolutely good enough to execute. 16-9.
Well, sometimes it is
17-9
or somebody young like that when you're trying to take a shot, a delicate net, and suddenly hit her opponent's right in front of her face.
She hasn't picked up a point since the interval, so it's really poor. Okay, that's the first one.
Sum is over.
10-17. Got to double figures again. Ah, she got it back. Three-quarter court's going to be tough. She'll be in charge of this rally. Nice play.
Yes, this nice play.
Didn't even have to come in with the power. Just nice touches. 18-10. She does look in control now. Okay, she's still hobbling a little bit, but definitely much more in control than we expected. Yeah, great shot. Well, she's had several. Since the interval, she's been in total control. Some great, great power plays, but also some fabulous net quality as well.
She should be in control with the opponent that she's
20,
had.
20, match point, 10.
Okay, it's match point now in this women's singles. It was 11-9. It's now 20-10, and that's it. She's not going to chase that one down. 11-20.
11-20.
Make the scoreboard symmetrical. You can get a point here. Come on. Good girl, that's 12.
12-20.
Or maybe right here.
Well, that would be a really good thing to take home with. Performance like this, 21-12 would be very, very good. And that is it. 21-12, 21-12. She dives despairingly, Airah Mae Nicole ALBO, but I tell you, she's put on a good show. 15 years old from the Philippines, and Ti Jing Yi, after starting so badly in this competition, has come through with two successes
Malaysia,
in a row.
21-12,
one last night where she was really, really looked dreadful. She was bedraggled and struggling. Today was much, much easier as you'd expect, and she obviously was confident that her health would hold out. She's done just that. 21-12, 21-12, and Malaysia are 2-0 to the good against the Philippines. So that's the situation after two matches here. Sixth day of competition in this round robin. Malaysia are certainly on the march now. They've got 2-0 against Philippines and could easily be 4-0 before the end, and that would make 2 4-0s in a row, and that'll push them up the league table, that's for sure. Right, well, we've got Tan and Tan. There can only be one thing, can't it? Tan Bunhyong and Tan.